Hey, good morning. It's your girl, Lisa D. Sparks, here with another edition of the Daily Sparks. And so, or I should say the not so Daily Sparks, because this is a very sporadic webcast. But I just had to share this information with you. It's funny to me. And it also, it teaches a lesson, and it really enforces something that I love to share and the seminars that I conduct. So this is a pure example. This is an object lesson from what I normally share in my sessions. So here it is. As you can see, I'm on the Wall Street Journal's website on their blog. It's called The Speakeasy. And if you notice the headline right here, it says Abercrombie & Fitch, the teen retailer. You know, the guys where I actually went in there one time to, you know, just on a lark. I was in the mall, and a large for them is the equivalent of a normal size 6, you know, and they don't even sell extra larges. Okay, so just to give you some context on what this brand is all about. So Abercrombie & Fitch offers to pay, quote, the situation, unquote, to stop wearing its clothes. I love it for so many reasons. Like, I just want to go nuts with this because it's brilliant on both sides. And so who's winning, you know, so to speak, or who gets the bragging rights here? You know, equally, it's phenomenal. So let's talk about the situation first. I am not a fan of the television show. I'll just put that, you know, out there right now, but I do know that it exists, okay? And there's a guy who, you know, because of his abdominal muscles, he likes to say that there's a situation, you know, going on. And so here's his picture, Mike Sorrentino, aka The Situation. So wow, what I love about this is that this guy, he's created such a brand for himself as like a kind of skeevish or, you know, weird guy who likes to go around, you know, showing his abs. He has such a solid brand that other brands are disassociating themselves with him. Perfect. I talk about firing clients in my seminars all the time. Like, if there's someone who's just really getting under your skin, who you absolutely cannot stand, and they're taking away all of your creative energy, you have to get away from them. But now this takes it a step further, where you're saying, you know what, I don't want you to use my products. Please do not use my products. So for people who have a very strong opinion that's negative about this situation guy, of which there are many, okay, I don't have anything against the guy, just, you know, it's not my cup of tea, okay? But there are some people, like, when you mention Jersey Shore, when you mention the situation, their eyes roll in the back of their head like 20 times, like a cartoon. It's insane, right? So for all of those people, Abercrombie and Fitch is now calling in their tribe. You know, it's like they're letting them know, okay, hey, we're not a part of this group. So anyone who totally doesn't like this situation guy, they could potentially be a customer for Abercrombie and Fitch. And I would even go further to say they may attract customers, because these people just want to support any brand that does not support the situation. So it's about definition. It's about brand definition. It's about telling people who you are with and who you're not with. In these days of, you know, social media marketing, it's really important to be transparent. And if you have an opinion, especially a very strong opinion about someone or something, just let it be known. So Abercrombie & Fitch has offered to pay this guy not to wear their stuff. It's a reverse endorsement, really. It's a reverse endorsement deal. And they're coming out and saying it publicly. I think it's absolutely amazing. Hopefully more brands will follow in these footsteps, just to let people know, hey, this is what we stand for. This is our brand. I mean, I could see, you know, Ralph Lauren, you know, paying, gosh, I don't know, maybe a gangster rapper, so to speak, not to wear their stuff. I mean, this can extend even beyond the fashion world, which is notoriously, gosh, shall we say catty? We'll say that in a very nice way. They can be notorious with their, I guess, divisions and okay, you're not in, or you're in, or you're out. This can extend beyond creative marketers, especially you small business marketers out there, all my buddies, my friends, my family, in small business marketing. Please really, you know, take this to heart. I would steal this strategy. The reverse endorsement is what I'm calling it. So check it out. All right, that's enough for today. This has been the Daily Sparks. I love you guys, and I'll see you next time. Bye.